What is the purpose of this wing tongue? Again for stability correction only. Wing tongue. Ballast tanks will be, the wing tongue is also ballast tank. These double bottom tanks also can be called ballast tanks also. So like this, suppose this is the ship. You are having double bottom here. So these tanks are different. These are all double bottom tanks at the bottom. Nowadays it is a requirement for oil tanker, you must have double bottom, because otherwise ship is going and touching somewhere in the ground. This there will be holes and the oil will go into the sea and pollute the sea. So you are having another bottom, that is called double bottom. So even if the ship is touching here, inside here these tanks there is no oil, all water or ballast water or something only. So oil is the, on top of this there is another cargo holds are there or tanks are there. So oil will not go and pollute the sea. So double bottom tanks are provided. Some of the double bottom tanks can be used as the ballast tanks. Or if you take the other way, I am taking a section, cutting here the ship. And then you look, or you look from the top, or it is called the plan view. You see from here, so this will be seen like a box only, like this way. And the length will be like this way. And then the cargo hold deck will be like this way. And there will be wing tanks, and below this you are having various tanks are there. Double bottom tanks. And here this is a four peak tank. The tank which is there on the front side of the vessel is four peak. This is also used for ballasting. And then you are having an aft peak tank, backside aft peak. So this is used for, again, either you carry fresh water or sea water to balance purposes only. So you are having various tanks are there. So this is the DB tank. DB tank means double bottom. That is why it is called double bottom DB tank. You are having wing tank, you are having ballast tank. Some of the DB tanks are called ballast tank, but you cannot carry oil inside the ballast tank. These are all dedicated, meant exclusively for this ballast purpose. Otherwise what happens? When you pump out water, oil will go, oily water will go, and you will pollute the whole area. Ballasting engineers, they will do. Who is responsible for seeing the trim and stability? Deck people. They are doing loading and everything. Loading and unloading, the deck people, deck department is responsible. Then who will help them starting the pump and everything? Engineers. Engineers have to start the pump and say according to the requirement, okay, you start the pump, we will start the pump. Engineers will start the pump and take the oil out or water out or whatever you want. If ballasting stability has to be corrected, like the way I was telling, then the chief officer is in charge of the load, or second officer is there on the duty, he will say, he will tell the engineer, okay, now ship is going here, so please load or ballast these on the other side, port side tanks 1, 2, whatever he will say. So accordingly the valves will be opened by the deck department. Engineers will start the pump and pump the water into this. So directing the water to the respective tanks or whatever tanks they want to load it, that is done by the deck department only. Engineers will start the pump and give water, supply water to the deck, and they will divert the water and fill up the tanks accordingly. Or you want the other way, take out the water from there, they will again open the concerned valves of the tanks and they will tell the engineers, please pump out water from here, we are having this side more, so we want to correct the stability of the vessel. So engineers will do the de-ballasting. The opposite of ballasting is called de-ballasting. Taking out of the water from the ship is called de-ballasting. Taking water into the ship, into the double bottom tanks or ballast dedicated tanks, and that is called ballasting. Yes. So hull is another thing. Hull is, the whole part is called hull. The complete part of the ship. Generally you can call it as a hull. Complete part. So you have the hull, you have the superstructure, you have the engine room. You are having ballast tanks, that is double bottom tanks or wing tanks you are having. Cargo spaces, again we have seen cargo spaces. So these are generally, you can call it, important parts of the ship. You can have a lot of other parts, as I was telling you, describing a human being. Same way, these are all only important parts of the vessel. So So you have seen, this is the superstructure. The superstructure, again we are dividing. Like for example, head, body, that head is there. On the head, you are having so many things. Two eyes are there, two ears are there, one nose is there, mouth is there, so many things are there. So previously you have seen the important parts of the ship. So I am explaining one by one. If you take the superstructure, what all things are there in the superstructure? Just like a head is having so many other things. So you are having galley. Galley is the place which is used for cooking food. Galley is the place where food is prepared, cooked. Accommodation, you are having, people have to stay. So you are having accommodation, very nice air conditioned houses or properly naturally ventilated or forced ventilation, accommodations are provided. Then you are having the navigational bridge. Navigational bridge are always on top, topmost place in the accommodation here, navigational bridge. Why it has to be on top? Vision, you have to see all around the ship. If it is somewhere here, so many things might obstruct the view of the navigating officers, those who are standing. So this is always on top of the deck, navigational bridge. It is called bridge actually, navigational bridge. So navigational bridge, and then you are having radio communication. Radio communication is there either in the navigational bridge or very close to that, because radio communication is required for the navigating officers. All the nowadays, previously, for example, when we were all sailing, there were radio officers. Separately, radio officers were there. They were doing all the weather forecasting, taking weather reports and everything, and giving information to the deck department, navigating department. They used to give report, tomorrow going to rain, very heavy rains or storm is going to be there. All these things will be, the message will be picked up by the radio officer. Various equipments are there called Navtex. Equipments are there. Through that, they will pick up, radio officer will pick up and pass on to that. Also, radio officer is in charge of the communication from the vessel to shore and receive the messages from the shore to ship. So radio officer is in charge of all these communicating equipments from the vessel ashore, shore to vessel. Now what happens, because of again, because of the reducing of number of people, personnel on board, officers etc., radio officers are there, not there nowadays. So the two of the navigating officers, like for example chief officer and second officer, they are supposed to pass the GMDSS certification, that is Globe Distress Maritime Communication System, the signal system, the GMDSS. They are supposed to pass the certificate of that, and they are responsible for the communication. Again, additional responsibility for the navigating officers. They have to do the communication examination also, and then they are responsible for that. Again, any ship, when there are so many people are staying, so you have to have store, various store, food for the store, for the food, store for various, keeping various other provisions or other things. Everything you require a store, for engineering, tools, everything you require a store. Then you have cargo control room. Inside the superstructure, you have a cargo control room somewhere very close to the main deck. This is the main deck. Very close to the main deck, you will be having the cargo control room. So from there only you will be able to, the duty officer will be able to control the cargo movement, loading, discharging, everything is controlled from the cargo control room, especially in a gas tanker or liquefied gas carrier. Whereas in a general cargo vessel, there is no separate cargo control room. The navigating officers will be moving around on the deck and they will be controlling the cargo from there. How many cranes are working? How much cargo is going inside, what cargo is going out. Everything is controlled by the navigating officer, second officer or third officer, chief officer, whosoever is on duty, he will control the cargo movements. But in cargo, this bulk liquid cargo like oil tanker, product carriers, gas tankers, you are having a separate cargo control room, air conditioned cargo control room. From there, all the movement of cargo are controlled. So this is the parts of, important parts of the superstructure. Captain is there always here on top only. Again, chief engineer in the accommodation also, captain and chief engineer's accommodation is on top only. And again, captain accommodation always on the starboard side. Chief engineer is always on the left side. Why? Ships, when they are crossing each other, you have to pass starboard side only. Suppose one ship is going like this way, other ship is coming, she cannot cross like this way, from the right side only, starboard side only, like this way. So captain has to see all the movements. When you are driving, you have to see and see whether it is going properly. Same way, captain is always, accommodation is always on the starboard side. So close vision is there when ship is passing out and everything. Chief engineer always, his work is not on the bridge or not outside, his engine room only. So he can be placed anywhere. But he is equivalent to the master. So the same deck only, but he is on the port side. Any ship you go and see that chief engineer's accommodation is provided on the port side, and on the starboard side, captain's accommodation is provided. And the green light, you are having lights are there, side lights on the ship. You are having headlight is there on the mast, side lights. The green side is on the starboard side. Port side, you are having red signal, red light. That means through green signal, collision regulation rules prescribes, international rules prescribe that you have to go by starboard side only, all this. So master will be able to see properly. Now we see the hull. Hull is the very important, the complete ship's hull. Again, let us divide like a body of a human being, hull. What all things are there? Hull has to have the forward side, means the front side, and it has to have the back side also. So that is called aft, A-F-T. In a ship, the backward side is called aft. Forward, of course, forward only. And the left side is called? What is left side? Port. 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 P-O-R-T. And right side is? Starboard side. So forward and forward side is there. Aft side is there. And then what all things are there? Midship. You are having the midship. Center of the vessel. You are having the poop. Decks are divided. Various decks are there. Poop deck, and then again on top of various deck, like accommodation you are having in a flat, various levels. So in the ship also various legs are there, poop deck is there. And then the main deck you are having mooring winches for tying up the vessel. Mooring on the forward side of the vessel here, you are having mooring winches on the forward side here. Here you are having the winches are here, windlass winches, and then ships are moored from here. Ropes will be going from there. I'll show you how the mooring is done in a ship. So mooring is here, then again sides in the tanker you are having on the sides also mooring, this side and that side. For example, if you see the plan view from the top, your side moorings are there and forward moorings are there, and aft back side you are having another winches, mooring winches on the back side. So forward side, aft side, port side, starboard side for a tanker, because going on, loading is going on very fast. It has to be moored properly, tied up properly to the jetty. So a lot of mooring arrangement is done. So mooring winches are there. Then windlass, again, the forward mooring winch is called the windlass. Windlass, windlass is the forward part. Mooring winch provided on the forward side, extreme forward side of the ship is called the windlass. And anchor, you all know anchor. What is anchor? Dropping the anchor and all that. Anchor goes down and hold on to the mud, and then ship is secured there. So anchor is there, two anchors will be there, one on either side, port side and starboard side. And then forecastle is the area, front area. This front area of the, after the cargo hold, the complete front area. If you see the vessel other way, this area, forward area is called the forecastle of the vessel. Name given, forecastle, castle and forecastle. Chain locker. What is this chain locker? Why chain is used in the ship? Lowering and lifting the anchor. Anchor, chain is used. So you will be having, windlass will be having, and through that two chains will be going there in the this side and that side. Chains will be there. Then you are having an anchor here. So chains will be there. Now on these chains, when you are heaving up the anchor, lifting up the anchor from the water, this will be lifted up, wound here. Electric motors or hydraulic motors will you will be turning and this anger will go up and up, and whatever chains are there, these chains, whatever is going, it goes inside the chain locker. There is a chain locker provided, a store sort of a thing, through a hose pipe. There is a steel pipe is there, through which the chain is going, taken back and put and stored inside in layers. Chain locker is there, and last end of the chain is tied up here. Last end of the chain is tied up here, and this goes outside and anchor is there. So it goes and stored inside the chain locker. That area where the chain is stored is called the chain locker, and the chain is used for throwing out or heaving up the anchor. So you are having all the parts of the ship, that is the hull side you are having.